Hello students, welcome in study skill, better understanding. Now, just we have to make our understandings better, and I'm going to tell you about Robert Lee Frost, an American poet. Robert Lee Frost was great American poet. He belongs to 20th century. He was born in San Francisco, California on 26th of March 1874, and he is known as American Grand Old Man of Poetry. It is very important term, you should note it. American Grand Old Man of Poetry, he was known as. And his father was William Prescott, mother Isabella Moody. She fond of writing verses, means her his mother was fond of writing verses, poems. His father nearly died in 1885 of tuberculosis. If we talk about family, he has two sons and four daughters. And these sons and daughters, I'm telling you also the name. In September 1896, birth of a son, Elliot, that he died due to cholera later. 1902, Carol, another son born. 1903, he had a daughter, that was Irma. In 1905, had another daughter, Marjorie. 1907, another daughter, Eleanor. And finally, in 1899, Leslie, she was another daughter of him. If we talk about wife that he married, she was his class fellow, classmate, Eleanor Miriam White. He married her on 19 December 1895, and there are some facts about his life. And his death occurred due to the cancer, 29th of January 1963, and his wife died in 1938 by cancer. She was also died by the cancer. Now he was renowned American poet. There are some facts I'm telling you. Actually, I'm habitual making videos with the facts, not more, you know, ideas which are not beneficial to us. Why I need to give you here? That's why there are only facts you should understand, you can get. His poems are known for regionalism. First things, regionalism. What is regionalism? Regionalism means he talks about his region, his own region, the area where he lives. Another thing, his poems represent New England and later America. Students, you know very well that New England is a part of America. Don't be confused that it may be that in England there is New England. No. It is in America. New England is in America. Some people of England had gone to America and they started living at a particular place, a type of colony, and its expansion had been done and it expanded so much, and later it is called New England because English people were there, people of England were there living, that's why this is called New England. So he was a poet of New England, which is later America. He is non-serious poet and also pastoral poet. Pastoral means what? Pastoral poet means what? The poet who talks about pastures. What means pasture? Pastoral word came from the word pasture. Pasture, a type of grassland, you know. So he was a pastoral poet means he was a poet of nature. He talks about nature. He talks about countryside. He talks about villagers. He talks about shepherds, like that. He is habitual for parenthesizing. Parenthesizing is a style, a type of a style used in English in doing paraphrases, in doing phrasal sentences and most effective sentences by phrasal sentences. And his very famous poem Stopping by Woods occurs in New Hampshire. It was a magazine, it was a collection of a poem, New Hampshire, first collection. So Stopping by Woods on a snow evening, this poem comes in. North of Boston is known as Book of People. This was also a collection of poems, North of Boston. This was very good and famous anthology of poems. And it is known as Book of People. This is a very important fact. My Butterfly is his first elegy poem. Very first elegy poem, My Butterfly. It was sold in $15 in 1894. Means that $15 at that time was a sound, a type of, you can say, the amount. The New York Independent, and the same year he published a collection of his poems entitled To Light, which included My Butterfly. Means this My Butterfly poem came in To Light. This is a collection of poem. His first poem, a ballad, entitled La Nostrustri, was published in School Bulletin. My Butterfly under the title To Light in 1895 is an edition of only two copies, one for his beloved and the other for himself. Means this My Butterfly, when he published To Light, So Twilight having two copies only published. One is for his beloved and another is for him. The publication of another poems like Trial by Existence in 1906. This was inspired by the Elizabeth and next he sold his farm and took the family to England in 1912. Means from America, from New England, he sold his farm, house, and then he came back to England in 1912. Not came back to England, means came England in 1912. And he had returned to America with his family in 1915. Means after 3 years, he came back to America, means New England. If we talk about degrees and honors, the Harvard University had given him the honorary degree, Doctorate of Letters, in 1937. And 12 times such degrees he conferred on. After that, he received 44 academic honors. 44 academic honors. You can get, you can think, you can analyze that how much talented person he was. 44 academic honors he got. He received the gold medal for poetry from the National Institute of Arts and Letters. He conferred for the Doctor of Humanities 3 times. He had taken 2 times master degrees and 17 times other degrees, honorary degrees he conferred. He was selected as Phi Beta Kappa poet. This is a very important term, you should understand, and I'll tell you later whole detail. But Phi Beta Kappa is a society there. This is a society, Phi Beta Kappa, and he was known poet of that society. His language was very simple, lucid, and very simple, and he always had written in a New England dialect. On the other hand, he got 4-time Pulitzer Prize. This is very, very important question. 4 times he got Pulitzer Prize. First in 1924 for the collection New Hampshire, second in 1931 for the collected poems, third in 1937 A Further Range, fourth in 1943 A Witness Tree. These were the 4 collections for he got 4 times Pulitzer Prize. I made a code for them, NCRT, that you can remember with this. N means New Hampshire, C stands for collected poems, and R stands for A Further Range. So I have taken R, first letter of range. So you should remember, because I have to make it meaningful, that's why I've taken it. A witness tree, that T is taken from the tree for the code. And another code of remembering these dates is 7, 6, 6. How? Because first he got in 24, after 7 years he got in 1931, then after 6 years he got in 1937, then after 6 years he got in 1943. So this would be, I think, very beneficial to you. So this is all about Robert Frost. There are some famous lines and different poems I will discuss later. And this is my series for PG and PGT. So I'm making of American poets. Just to follow, continue and watch videos and get the understanding whatever I convey to you. Thank you so much, students. Thanks a lot.